Hello everyone, Buzz Killington here, and I have something new for you guys tonight. I have succeeded in unlocking, thanks to my friends in it with the devs, we have unlocked Thaddeus Noble, and that will allow me to take part in the Fall of Cadia Mirror campaign. I think what I'm going to do is do the first 7 or 8 missions tonight and in this video, and do the balance up until the boss on a second video. I think that's the way I'm going to do things. There's got a lot of stuff to go through, but first let's take a look at Thaddeus Noble. For those of you who don't have him already, he's the Master of Ordnance. That rumbling of thunder is actually the rumbling of the artillery he's calling in. You can see he's got a basilisk barrage. If he has not moved, unleash a barrage of 5 shells on any target on the battlefield doing da-di-da-di-da. 3 randomly hit the target hex or surrounding hex. So basically, don't expect precision bombardment. For each round that has ended, 1 more of the shells hits the target hex. So basically, the longer you hold off using his ability, the more accurate it will be. You can think of it as terms of the spotters being able to better focus in or something like that, if it helps you. Oh, speaking of which, spotter is his passive. Friendly units within 2 hexes with the trait heavy weapon deal plus 11 damage or plus 14 damage. Now, there aren't many that applies to. It could apply to in arena, but among the Imperial, I think... no, there aren't actually. Who's he got? Who actually... Who among the Imperials actually has a heavy weapon? Oh, it might actually be Certus. Let me just check. Because, oh, he's just a sniper rifle. That actually doesn't count. Maybe... Well, I don't know. I'd have to find out which guys have got the trait, because I can't actually see a lot of them right now. So that does make it a bit of a problem. But, in any case, let's get things started. We're going to start... I thought I had this upgrade just a minute ago. I thought I'd looked for this. I thought I'd found it. Oh well. We're going to apply the... we're going to just get a few upgrades back for him. We just want to level him a little bit, not too much. I don't want to use up too much of my energy, as you guys obviously know. Ooh. Oh no! What happened there? Oh, it's glitching out. I just lost the upgrade again. Yeah, there's definitely some kind of weird glitch going on there. But let's give him a bit of energy. He's leveled up there. We can apply... Oh, he's lost the upgrade again. What's going on there? Because I definitely found that. I definitely found that before. That's really weird. Okay, guys, bear with me. I'm just going to have to... restart the game for a second and see if I can work out what's going on with that, because that's something I'm going to have to report to the devs. If not, which is a bit of a pain, that, but oh well. We don't need it particularly for this anyway, so we'll just push on, see what happens, I guess. All right, we've got the reload in, and yeah, I've got these upgrades unlocked, but for some reason I have lost access to the cool stuff. So I'll just give him a couple of bits of equipment for now. All the rare stuff is taken at the moment, so we'll just have to make do. I guess I'll try one more time, see if I can grab it. Okay, there you go. You can see we've got it. And we go and apply it, and my kitten is deciding he wants my attention, which is a terrible time to do it. But so let's try this one more time, see if we end up losing it. And if it happens, it's just something I'm going to have to talk to the devs about. Yeah, it's gone. Yeah, click away from the screen and it disappears. That's so weird. See, I've lost the upgrade again. And if I come back, yeah, it's gone again. That's so strange. All right, well, I'm just going to... use a couple of badges leveling him just a little bit. We're gonna drop 1 Chronicle of War. As you can see, I may have used up a few of mine. There we go, and we'll just... There you are. So we've got him up to Got him up to 7 on his ability there. That's okay for the moment. We'll get that with more stuff soon. But yeah, losing the upgrades there is definitely an odd one. Don't really know what to make of that. But we'll get on with the campaign in the meantime. For some reason, it's defaulted back to this, which is kind of irritating. All right, so mission number one. We got some blood letters. Their abilities are unstoppable ferocity, which I assume means they can't be broken. They won't retreat. But that's okay. We'll take them on. Let's see who we need to use. Cut Skoden, Sybil Divine, and Thaddeus Noble have to be deployed. All right, so we have a lot of troops available here. A lot of troops we're up against here. The Bloodletters, they have a movement of 3, so they can't reach us. What I'm going to do is just let them come forward this turn. All right, and now we're going to try the bombardment. We're going to see what happens. Just target the middle of it. Nice, it comes in. It got some good damage done there. And now I'm going to get him in the middle. Use his active. That didn't do as much as I'd hoped it would, but that's fine. Oh wow, he dies. He's pretty weak at the moment. He is pretty weedy right now. So yeah, he is very underleveled compared to the others. So we got to keep him protected or he's just going to die straight away. But as we know, we have that slight issue of not being able to apply upgrades to him at the moment. Alright, so we took one out. You can see the difference there. It didn't really get a lot done. But I'm going to pull these guys forward. Going to get Cut Skoden to tank a few hits. Sybil Divine does alright. Okay, so we're going to throw this in. That gets the damage done. So what does her ability do? Psychic Maelstrom. Let's use the active. Didn't get any work done. Let's see. There we go. His ability does work there. So there we are. We've got one battle with him deployed and surviving the battle. I've had that quest for a long time, so it is nice to be able to unlock it. I might just do 5 missions, actually. Until I work out what's going on with this glitch, it would be nice to be actually, able to level him. That would be cool. Oh, wow. I can promote him. Okay. Don't know how that happened. But he's now up to 5 stars. I still can't use these upgrades for some reason, but that's all right. Yeah, he's a little bit weedy right now, but he's been strengthened just a little bit, so we'll push on. Oh, wow. Chaos Terminator. Wow, I've never encountered one of them before, so this should be really cool. I was wondering what kind of Chaos characters you'd end up getting against this, but yeah, him right in the middle there. The Chaos Terminator's bound to be slow, though. So, oh god, he's going to be able to teleport. Alright, so we're going to let him... Wow, he teleports right in and he fires on us. Alright, so we're going to use the ability straight away. Take him out. That's good. I like that. Ah, Cut Skoden's crack grenade works really nicely there. And, the ability didn't do very much. Yeah, I'm going to need to try her normal attack and see how effective that is. Because that special ability isn't really doing a lot for me at the moment. But yeah, unlike Angrax, that Chaos Terminator can just arrive right next to you and fire on you. Which, yeah, that's different. Oh, 2 Chaos Terminators, 4 Bloodletters this time. Okay, so as I say, they can teleport pretty close to you. And we're stuck again with the same ones as before. So how are we going to do this? I forgot to press start. Press start too soon. That was unfortunate on my part. What can we do? Well, we can't really do much of anything at the moment. Let's let them come forward. All right. Then we're going to get Cut Skoden into the middle here. His crack grenade does do a lot of good work. We are relying on the active to get us through at the moment. And Sybil Divine rounds the set off. So yeah, I am liking the fact you get a lot of new opponents. Bloodletters. You get new Chaos Terminators to face. I was hoping for Chaos Cultists. Maybe that's something that will come in a future video. I don't know. Don't know what's going on with that, but we'll have a look. Okay, so one Terminator, 7 Bloodletters. Not a lot of ranged options for these guys. So, oof, okay. And we're going to do a little bit of repositioning here. We always want to keep Thaddeus Noble at the back. And once again, I think we're going to let them come forward. We are going to let them come forward. We're going to use his active again. It does seem to be pretty effective. So we're going to strike here. See how many bloodletters we can get. We're going to use his ability to take this guy out for sure. And then we're going to hold back. That's fine. Nice. That's what we want. And they are. Job done. So with these guys, it does seem worthwhile maybe just to hold back, let them come to you, give his ability active that little bit more punch than it had before. And yeah, the bloodletter numbers are just increasing. The demons are noticing we're in the area and they are starting to swarm us. No Terminators this time. Oh wow, there is a Terminator. He's actually right there. Right there. So what we might do here... This ability would have no... You can't target this guy, which is... That sucks a little bit. So I'm just going to move here and not do anything. Okay, then we're going to hit right in the middle here. That was some good damage. Next, we're going to throw in this concussive grenade attack. And that takes 3 out very nicely. Her passive takes 2 out. And one more comes in. My boy Thaddeus can take him out. But yeah, it's a combination of actives that really gets you through here. I mean, to be honest, her normal attack is so much more impressive than the active one. I'm going to have a quick look at what she does. Let's have a quick glance at her ability. So her active is... 75% chance to score another hit. If it does, 50% chance to score another hit. Oh, okay, so it arcs. But you've got to improve the odds of trying to get there. Alright, that's fine. Okay, so... Wow, look, it's back. It's back. Confusingly. If it stays... Is it going to work? And it's lagged. It's locked up. Yeah, and it's gone wrong again. I just don't understand what's going on with this. Let's try one more time and see if we can get it to work. Nope, it's just not going to go. It wants to level. But yeah, it does the music and just nothing seems to be happening there. That's so strange. Well, definitely one for the devs. Definitely one for the devs to have a go at. Alright, I'm going to try and do a couple more. I've just got enough energy left to pull that off. So we'll do mission 6. And... Pull these guys. Who have we got? Oh, that's a lot of bloodletters coming at us. Once again, we're going to let the swarm of demons come forward. They seem to be coming forward in 2 pretty distinct groups, so we're going to start by hitting this group right here. That's gone okay. And then we're going to throw Cut Skodan right in the middle here. And yeah, that's pretty cool damage. All right, let's see what the active can do. And again, it didn't actually... Wow. The active really isn't impressing me at the moment for her. As you can see, he died. So that really wasn't very good news for me. So I'd have to try it again. I need that 100% score, you guys. I really do. Alright, in we go again. The active comes in, takes 2 out. We're going to send Cut Skodan in here. His grenade should do a lot of damage. That's really good damage. Alright, and we're going to use her normal attack, which takes 2 out no problem. There you go. Thaddeus Noble is taking the brunt of the attacks as well. They know he's weak. They know he's weak, and it's really working for them. So yeah, there you go. That is the first 6 missions done. I'm now out of energy, so I'm not really going to be able to do that anymore. Ooh, 4 Terminators next time around. So that'll be an interesting one. But yeah, I'm going to have to get on to the devs, file a bug report. I don't know what seems to be going on here. Stone rank 1. You'd think you'd be able to rank up, but apparently you cannot at the moment. Still, there we go. I hope you have enjoyed this little look at Fall of Cadia. A little bit of an insight into Thaddeus, and hopefully this next time I do this video, he'll be fixed. I don't quite know what's going on there. But yeah, you know what to do. Like, subscribe. Feel free to check out my other videos. I am trying to build my presence on YouTube, so if you want to check out the videos, really help increase my watch hours, help me get that one step closer to monetization. Anyway, thank you guys, and I'll see you on the next video.